Hey guys, and welcome to a showdown featuring myself, a rubber duck of war, leading the High Elves here up against Urgaze and the Bretonnian forces on Dot Karaz. And we will be focusing around the High Elves at the moment because I've seen a lot of chatter now that Beastmen have finally awoken from their never-ending slumber to actually become beasts in multiplayer. A lot of people are saying High Elves and Norska in particular have kind of taken their place and become the new Beastmen. So what do I think on such talk? And do the High Elves still pack a bit of a punch? Or are they really just that bad? Well, High Elves in general are quite an odd faction, particularly because they actually have some matchups they're incredible in. Vampire Counts, for example, Dwarfs, and a load of other ones they are relatively solid in. But let's have a look at the builds anyway of this particular battle, and we'll talk more about the High Elves as we go along. So we have Spearmen, cheap and cheerful, or as at least cheap as you can get with the High Elves. They're a rather expensive bunch, dotted all the way along the front line, backed up by an insane number of archers. Now, archers are certainly a strength of the High Elf faction in general, being able to pour on that long-range firepower is always quite tasty. We're also going for triple line chariots here. You can see them dotted all the way along. Their main job is to protect these archers, cycle charge the enemy in the front line, and they have decent AP and staying power to attempt to deal with enemy cavalry, particularly when they're rolling dirty with one of the coolest characters on the High Elf roster by far, Tyrion. Super underrated, can go toe-to-toe with most enemy characters and monsters in the game, coming in with some pretty useful abilities like Sunfang, as well as Feint and Reaperzort, is what I'm going to call it, Reaperzort. Who knows how you say that? I'm sure someone will tell me down below. We have Stand Your Ground as well, Foeseeker and Heart of Avalon. Heart of Avalon can be a little bit annoying because often Tyrion will break before he gets that juicy restore of nearly 2,000 hit points. He's going to be rolling alongside a Mage of Metal, simply coming in with Final Transmutation, and that is it for the spells. And that's going to be our build in a nutshell. For my opponent, we do have a bucket ton of peasant mobs dotted in the front line. Filthy, very unhappy to be here, but they will be putting their lives on the line for King Leon Leonker. And if he asks you to come fight to the death for him, you better answer, otherwise Beaky is going to get a little bit upset with you. Coming in, it would seem, with all the goodies. So we have the Sword of Corone, the Line Shield, Stand Your Ground, and Foeseeker. In the secondary line, we have a couple of units of foot squires. Not a big fan of these units, but they are anti-infantry armor piercing. Should do relatively good up against spearmen and other such troops. In that central pocket, we have a silver chevroned filled trebuchet. A little bit risky because bolt throws aren't uncommon here, but at the same time, it can pay off in absolute abundance. We have some peasant archers as well, dotted in the back, protected by spearmen arms, and then an insane amount of cavalry. 1, 2, 3, 4 units of Questing Knights, some of the best cavalry in the game, being anti-infantry armor piercing, but good enough stats, they can tend to drag their way through enemy cavalry. And of course, bringing the king, bringing so many Questing Knights, we have a Damsel of Life with Earthblood as well as Shield of Thorns. So without further ado, let's get this battle underway. Now, one big problem the High Elves do suffer from is being quite expensive and really squishy, meaning they are incredibly micro-intensive. Now, we still do see them at tournaments, which I really am a big fan of, happy people bring them, because I think they can be pretty insanely powerful, but at the same time, very risky, and can be punished for any small mistake. And that is why High Elves, I think, are rated so lowly on so many people's kind of tier lists and where they think they are in the game. And to a point, I do agree, are they as bad as Norska? Probably not, because at least they are a little bit more versatile and can abuse certain mechanics, such as healing spam, something Norska really lacks. Healing up your single entities is always rather good. But here today, we've gone for the much cooler chariots, the lion chariots, who dive in on those peasants. Oh my god, that's a bad trip to the zoo. A few of these peasants are going to be getting up again, but yeah, the lions are going to have an absolute whale of a time. Already up to 6 kills, peasants are close to breaking. And now our archers have pushed up, we're going to be able to engage this field trebuchet from long range, and this is absolutely 100% what we want. My opponent does try to react quite quickly and pull back with the field trebuchet, but it's a little bit too little too late there, and it is already broken off the field. Peasant mobs do drive forward, but the lion chariots shall meet them, lion to man, hitting and running wherever possible, as the spearmen also move ahead of the archers here. And these poor peasants, oh my god, look at the blood and carnage. Those lions really do have a taste for man flesh right now, but Questing Knights are going to be counter-charging us, which is a little bit scary, as our archers are currently focusing on those peasant bowmen, and you can see chariots continue to cycle charge the peasants wherever possible. We did manage to drag the Questing Knights into the spearmen, but they don't have the greatest damage output stats, so it's still going to be a bit of a struggle, but we catch them with an upgraded Final Transmutation, hitting the Questing Knights as well as the king, and in comes Tyrion, and Tyrion is scared of no man. He'll duel King Leon... attacking Leon Kerr, there we go, get all my words out, in quite ease, to be honest, particularly when his buffs are popped. The king does not want to stand around up against the might of Tyrion. Now, Question Knights are getting into our back line. You can see some of our archers are being focus fired down as well, but a mixture of spearmen pinning in the enemy with the line chariots doing a really good job actually taking down these expensive quest knights. And in the back line, we even have both line chariots pulling back to help protect the archers as Tyrion does drive his steed to greater feats of heroism, driving back and cutting down some quest knights as he does indeed go, having an absolute good time so far, breaking off that unit. Now, Archline is relatively okay, some of it's compromised. We managed to shatter some Questing Knights, and now the Lion Chariots are roaming in the back line, shutting down Peasant Bowmen, and we bounce in between all of these routing units, and one unit's trying to come back, just trying to finish them off, surround them, and drag them down where possible. But we do have to be a little bit careful. King Leon Kerr is an absolute menace in the night, and we have a full health unit of Questing Knights driving themselves into the heart of our build, hopping onto the archers, though some spearmen are starting to come back in an attempt to aid them at least. Question Knights are trying to sneak around these spearmen, and I'm not sure if they're going to be able to do it. Spearmen, get those little spears in the way, and do start to try to poke them down, but unfortunately we can simply get run over, and the Question Knights do pull themselves back here. It looks like Sword of Crone has gone down, nuking the stats of all of our troops here, and now there's going to be another big blob fight. The Question Knights are surrounding some of our archers. Lion Chariots are here, but more importantly, so is Tyrion. Even with the weakness to his armor and melee defense here, he can still pack a massive punch. And Earthblood does come down to try to keep these Question Knights fighting, the Spearmen desperately trying to hold back and aid Tyrion where possible. In the back line, you can see the Lion Chariots do manage to break off the field trip show once more, and they're going to be hunting this damn Sword of Life's booty wherever possible. If we can hop on her and shut her down, the lack of healing to the Question Knights is really going to start to pay into our favour. Big Fat Sunfang is going to go down here on the Peasant Mobs and Spearmen, just trying to clear out the chaff, so we can really deal with that cavalry a lot better than we currently are. Tyrion up to 101 kills so far, and he's been hunting down key targets all day, once again pulling himself back into these Question Knights, where with every swing of his mighty Sunfang, he should be able to slay a model. Spearmen are here trying to protect their archers alongside the chariots, and I'm really using their mass to pin in that cavalry, buying time for the Spearmen to get in there with their bonus versus large and do some decent damage. There may be a Shield of Thorns down here, but that's not going to protect you too well from a final transmutation and a rather angry Tyrion. Both units get to the point of breaking. One shatters, the other starts to rout and probably isn't going to be too long for this world. Down to just 600 HP, they will probably shatter in a few moments. And our archer line is once again back online, firing into peasants and kings alike. Spearmen dragging themselves back now to the main core of our force. In the back lines, spearmen are darting it towards the aid of the Lion Chariots, who are doing a decent job surrounding the damsels, shutting down these archers. There are a few Question Knights sniffing around, so having the spearmen nearby is always quite a good little nice thing to have in the back pocket. Over in the main fight, once again, the king does land. Lion Shield has been popped on him. The Mage of Metal giving him a little bit of peace of her mind there, and Tyrion continue to hunt down the king. Unfortunately, the king is simply going to float up into the sky, and he's a little bit of a slippery devil to catch sometimes. Archers, though, will be focus firing him down where possible. We're just trying to apply pressure. I can see his healing cap. The rest of his build isn't much of a concern for me. We still have a load of Lion Chariots left, which can kill an infinite amount of infantry, particularly when supported by Tyrion here, and just wave after wave of elvish pointy-eared spearmen. You can see we still have four units of spearmen alive and active here, driving away the core of the Bretonnian forces. And in the back lines, the Lion Chariots have been caught by the Question Knights, but not before shattering some peasant mobs. You can see the Damsel of Life is getting danger low as well. And likewise, the Question Knights know they should be better than my chariots in combat, still having a bit of a rough time. The remnants of our archer corps is very beat up at the moment, although all units do still survive. I'm going to continue to pressure the king as Tyrion gets in here, looking for that fatal jewel. I've been trying to hunt it down all game, wanting to get the 1v1, trusting in Tyrion, and the fact people underrate him quite often in these duel situations. But my opponent is a rather crafty devil, falling back and never really giving Tyrion too many opportunities to kill the king. Lion Chariots going to be quite happy now just to cycle charge some peasant mobs into a early grave, as big old puffs of blood are left on the ground, and the peasants used to the mud won't be too happy there though still, and they are indeed shattered. Sword of Crone does come in, trying to nuke Tyrion stats once more, but he does not care one little bit. We still have the heart in us, the heart of Avalon, and I'm not too fussed if the king does turn around and get some good hits in, because I still have a load of archers to support, as well as a bucket ton of spearmen. It looks like Armalos's is kicking in just as the Field Trebuchet crew get back on their war machine, and it shall be a Pyrrhic victory for the forces of the High Elves. It is indeed still possible to win with High Elves, have no fear. Well played there. I'm sorry if I'm butchering your name. Urgis is what I'm kind of going for there. You played very well, champ, and awesome build as well. I like the Field Trebuchet. I think there's a risk which didn't pay off here, but apart from that, the build was relatively solid. I'm going to talk a little bit more about the High Elves in just a second, as well as go through all the damage dealt, damage value of all the units. You can see Tyrion here performing absolutely fantastic, as I think he often does. But before we get to that, if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a big fat thumbs up. Subscribe for more Total War Warhammer content going into the future. We drop a video basically every single day and a couple of streams 2 to 3 times a week. Comment down below as well. What did you think of this battle? Who was your MVP? Do you like the High Elves? Do you hate the High Elves? Do you think they're really underpowered in their current state? And if so, why? I'd really like to know your feelings. I'm sure if there's any Dwarf mains out there or Vampire Count mains, they're going to be cursed in this video and say no, High Elves are too powerful, at least in our books, big grudge books, no doubt. There are links down below in the description to my Patreon if you'd like to support me and the channel, as well to my Games Planet account, where you can get basically any game on Steam, including all the Warhammer ones, at a discounted price. Also a link to my Discord where you can submit replays, get involved in the events that I host, tournaments, King of the Hills, all that good stuff, and chill out with a load of cool people. But wait, back to the battle, the High Elves and the Bretonnia. How did the units fare? Well, 2,185 damage value on Tyrion is pretty damn impressive, considering he barely had a scratch on him. Using the Sunfang just to clear out the chaff is always quite nice. My main problem with Tyrion is he does not have much mass whatsoever. If Tyrion was on a chariot, he'd be a world beater, but unfortunately, on his Elvish steed, which is quite slight in nature, unfortunately, he can get bogged down by infantry. Luckily, Sunfang can sometimes clear the path for him to escape, and if he gets mobility on the battlefield, he can really hunt down characters with amazing effectiveness. He's a good assassin all round. The Major Mel did her job as expected, coming in with those big nukes on the cavalry when they did bundle around my archers, chariots, or Tyrion. Again, 1.4k damage value is certainly not shabby whatsoever, including 66 kills. Very good work by her. And the spearmen across the board did a solid job, a lot of them paying for themselves and just holding back the enemy lines, allowing the rest of my build to really dish it out. The archers, 1,000 damage value, 500, 647, 818, and 621. Mwah. Beautiful work by them. These guys did a wonderful job just slowly dragging down the key elements of the Bretonnian build. If the Bretonnians would get left with a load of peasants, I'm completely comfortable, because look at the kills on these chariots. I'm not expecting them to get the most damage value. A lot of their time was spent just running over the enemy, but something the High Elves really do suffer with is wide builds, and that's really meta right now. So going really wide or bringing a ton of range potential, both ends are fantastic against the Elvish forces, because again, as we said, they're really elite and low HP, not very tanky. That can cause problems for them, but I think the Lion Chariot's one of those units which does address that problem slightly. 10,000 damage dealt, 156 kills, and 766 damage value. Not shabby whatsoever. The other one, 576 damage value, but still 87 kills. The final one, 1,132 damage value. So again, the most damage value of all these lads, and 136 kills, just assassinating those archers and those peasant mobs. And those elements of the Bretonnian build are what makes the Quest Knights so good, because they can saturate on top of cheap troops and buy time for range options. You take that away from them and the Quest Knights are all but useless. So yeah, all round I think High Elves are in a rough spot. I do think they're not great in the current meta, which certainly isn't helping them here. Single entities like dragons and so forth really suffer under the skirmish presence we're seeing quite a lot in tournaments, as well as a big old wide build. So that may change. We haven't had too much time to test stuff in a tournament arena just yet, with all the changes to DLC. So maybe High Elves are a bit better off than we think. But yeah, let me guys know your thoughts. As for King Leon Leon Kerr, 1,172 damage value, not too shabby whatsoever, though he is more expensive than Tyrion and performing quite considerably worse, but simply because he was being hounded at all opportunities. Damsel of Life did some good healing, that's what she's there for. And the peasant mobs, of course, got run over, which is kind of what they're for. We got 21 kills on a peasant mob unit. All bow before the might of the peasants there. That unit must have got on top of some archers, but the rest of the infantry in general just really got ran down there by those chariots, and the archers even failed to pay for themselves, which isn't something you see every day with peasant mobs being so cost effective. As for the Questing Knights, 1,000 damage value, 1,178, 537 and 444. So a real mixed bag there, some being neutered quite effectively, others still doing the great phase work for her. The field trip sheet, unfortunately, my opponent allowed me to get too close. He should have pushed out a lot more of his build, forced me to go all the way around the outside to shut it down or push through those chariots. But allowing the archers to get in range of your artillery is a death sentence for them because they have such a low unit count. The arrows really do add up, and those peasants simply cannot withstand the arrows that blot out the sun. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. Until next time, peace, peace. And as always, stay awesome.